us. Excuse me.
You know what? Let me get out of the way.
Thanks.
Nobody cooks in the kitchen.
What's this table for? Probably not for us.
I don't know what we're using it.
They
the
set it up.
Not ready yet, so I got a week to put these on.
Let's unload the flour with this. Let them.
And I text you, because my phone just says buy it.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't really pay much attention to that flavor.
Yeah, we made it.
Double brains.
Was there a paper in
I should have taken a picture from
the back.
The box seat? You
need a paper, piece of paper? What kind of paper?
Regular piece of paper.
It's like a list?
Yeah.
There might be. I'll go look.
Going nowhere.
Hey, you need this, though. Do you want this?
That's America.
Keep it in here. I'm going to stuff it in your...
These are for the card table.
Okay.
I don't know where the card table is going to be.
Okay. Once we figure out where they tell us, that's going to be the...
A little more involved than Jen's. That one goes outside. Are you getting me before I get hammered?
Hammered?
Shit keeps going wrong. Wait.
We're going down.
Everything's going good, right?
And then guys.
We meet
you
this
hang
like
the
mud puddle.
Yeah.
And when I say mud puddle, I mean it's like a pit of water. Okay. I'm like, ooh, man, I don't know, man.
Just
anyone. I got my four wheeler.
Make it look
which
good.
I'm like, I could do this. He's
make
got his little mini dirt bike.
You have a vision? I don't.
That he's driving. I'm like, you know, I don't know.
Bigger, what Michael,
do goes,
I can
yeah,
do
it.
Help him.
Hey, Scott, he goes,
video
go ahead. I'm like, no.
What's all this?
That might be for the women. No, I'm like, you go first.
I just. Carried all the flowers in and did all the other shit.
Where have you been all day?
I carry flowers in just like you did.
Okay, that's one task out of how many?
Probably mix the little ones with the big ones.
You don't want to.
Scott, are they supposed to be taking care of the chairs?
Yeah. No, they're going to
set them. He's doing something about that.
Yeah, the guy in there, he's going to set them up.
The guy offered to take, because the table's got to go somewhere.
What are those things?
These are lanterns for the...
Yeah. Oh my god.
There's little ones, big ones.
I want to go through it, but I don't want to go through it unless I have another four-wheeler in case they get stuck.
Is there instructions? Here's instructions.
You put them in like this, and then these top two pieces there.
Right here's instructions.
Hook inside this, there's so flip yours around.
How do you do it?
It's going to hold there, and then you pull this up, and these two things hook in.
It's even written in English.
But you don't need that because she already knows.
Kim's a teacher. She knows everything.
Right?
She's I don't know.
Oh, I got
she
it.
Says she's right. A teacher.
Just
like
that.
That.
Very
you
got to
pull them up and over.
Farther?
No. Where are those things? Yeah, this has to come
harder.
Up and over.
Harder. Lanterns.
Us.
They look like they require a lot of thinking.
Something you're not good at.
Not that I'm not good at.
I can't do that.
Unless there's like
seriously. A life at stake, I just don't want to...
You just don't want to deal with it?
Expend the energy.
Got it.
I'm guessing, these are to tie them up.
Where are they going?
In the trees.
Do one side at a time.
As long as they don't block the camera.
Let me take a couple.
Like that one right there.
Where does it go? Like right here?
Wait.
Yeah, they go inside that.
Wait. I'll grab some of that string there.
You gonna put the lights in them first?
Yeah, you wanna put the lights in them.
Yeah, they're
right here, buddy.
No,
little blinking lights.
So who's gonna do the magical spell for them to light up?
Yeah.
I'm not that good with Latin these days.
Oh wow, just like the ones you put in balloons.
That's where you come in there, Justin.
You twist it, you're just gonna hang this off that, I'm assuming.
Oh yeah, a little hook there.
I would think.
Just like, I just went over the top, that way it won't fall.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah.
I recorded for a little bit, and I'm like, come watch this
what do you say?
We and the ancestors meet the...
Yeah, my cousin.
You can't,
my cousin.
Your cousin?
Oh, yeah. Did you just rip one?
A
You're fired. Uh-oh.
So minus one, and you can no longer touch them.
You are fired.
I get the third fight. So I go get
She's the boss. You're fired. I agree.
You got the weakest link there, but somehow.
I'm
just
saying,
maybe I'll just go hang them up. So.
I'm Wayne's fiance. I don't know. Yeah. This is what he'll be doing on my wedding day, too.
All right. Hanging balls.
No, he'll be standing there doing nothing.
What are you... You need ribbon, right?
You are look dignified.
Did you probably don't have your knife?
Oh, I got scissors.
Are they in there?
I had to put it.
Can say you actually.
Put it in the back of the fucking
here, I'll put a few set those down.
All the way back, and, like,
and hold those. He's gonna need them.
And those got the bulbs in them.
I should have left door, but I just.
Where'd your hook go?
Rest of your life. Even after you get divorced.
They're still ruining you.
We
gotta
move these things when she has to take a picture. Put them on the table.
That's what she said yesterday.
Thank you very much.
She might not want
you. We're having to have people set up last
night. Yep.
Awesome. Last thing I gotta do is put this under her chair.
I think that you have that table all set up and everything like that. So.
And now we play the waiting game.
Yep.
Here we are.
Here everybody is.
And man of the hour walking away there. Now we can see him go.
He looks nervous.
And tomorrow he becomes a real man.
What are you searching for?
Not even tomorrow.
All right.
The one zipper to the
end. Oh, you look like you were...
Good for Katie not giving up on him.
I broke it, but
true.
All right.
I'm out of here.
All right. Well, let's make our way over there.
Oh boy.
Those people are confused.
What time is it? Oh boy, I better turn the cameras on here soon.
Disco ball
again. What?
dropping the pin. That's what he's doing.
Hey, where are these things going?
Okay. How are you doing it?
Can't see the pin, right? He's doing this. He's folding it over and putting the pin.
Yeah, what am I doing? The pin's not going in.
I thought I was supposed to pinch through the thing.
But he's trying to get it straight in, and it's not going to go straight into the flower.
Which one's mine?
Purple rose. Plain purple rose.
In the box.
In the box. In the box.
This one?
Yeah.
There's no point on the pin.
Leaf toward you.
Is that going to be on the right side?
Leaf, right?
Yeah. Be just like that.
Alright. You need help.
Okay. Yeah, I need help. It's going to be backwards, that's why.
There we go.
Oops, sir.
How's that?
Let me see how his looks.
It'll have to be backwards like this.
Was he able to get... Yeah,
yeah,
to
yes, the rose has to show.
Yeah, that's funny, but I... Let me know how mine looks. I don't know how I'm going to pull it from back.
Cool. I appreciate it. We got more pins.
There she is.
Hang on to that.
He's exaggerating.
He's not here yet. He went.
You went to get Kate.
Yeah. He came to change. Oh, didn't go get
I'm teasing him. He's playing occasion of the Southern Comfort. With
hey, that camera's running.
All right, thanks.
Justin,
the camera's running.
Oh, okay.
You want to be careful.
Oh, you get some awkward
anything you
on
say
that
can be used against you in the court of law.
So I went to Mardi Gras, right?
If you need an attorney,
there was
if
this
you
chick
will be provided
looking for a sister of a friend, and
she was cute.
Got tangled up with some.
So I'm talking to her. Everything's going good, right? And I bring her back because I'm gonna sow my roots.
Okay.
Can I tell you that? Is that okay? Mary Margaret?
Yeah, it's fine.
That's okay. No judgment, right?
No.
In my culture, that's what you do. Turns out, it was a man. Jeez. Worst $50 I've ever spent. Hey, Terry.
Hey.
Oh, you probably want this back.
Here we go. You didn't say anything bad in there, did you?
I get a water. Can I get an IV? This is bloody hot here.
See, you're
going to
get married.
I can put your IV on.
This is
that's true. We got professional here.
That's what I do.
I got some nice veins, trust me.
Oh, we'll go for the 18 then.
I got like nurse porn veins.
Yeah, all right. We won't even mess around. We'll go right for the big ones.
Outstanding.
Instead of fluid,
I got like... I'll just spit down an IV.
I got 2 weeks here. Let me put mine away.
To the reception.
Good. Give it back to your best man, all right?
Actually, I've never even seen it.
Is this your dad here?
Yeah.
Get in with your son. We gotta get you two
take
together.
Take that.
Buddy shot, real close there. That's what I like. Nice.
What was that line of those?
We're gonna keep working with this camera.
We got
smiles.
Chains. What she says
nice.
Chains.
Nice. One more like that. Let's go one more formal. Bring your hand down. Stand next to him. Okay, we'll turn just a little bit. Look it out that way. Like
look at me, buddy, with those beautiful blue eyes.
Looking over there. That's what we want. Both of you over there.
Look at Wayne.
Nice soft smile. Like that looks good.
Beer pong.
Okay, another one like that. Nice. All right. Very good. Great. Okay. Good photo.
You're gonna make him miss this shot.
All right.
All right. Should we get all the guys together again?
There you go.
Come in.
All right.
We're looking for a few good men.
Kay's not in there, is she?
No, I don't think she's here yet.
I think she's.
Oh, we gotta do this.
Somebody look and see if Katie's in the car.
Yeah, there.
No, I don't think so.
Negative.
No.
Negative.
He drove around.
Negative. Negative.
Bump into her.
Get to that guy's back here.
Yeah, you stay out of there. She probably dropped her off on the other side.
Well, I knew he was going to pick her up. So. Yeah, I dropped you. Thank you.
Yeah, I see him. They went around.
Good.
Your
call.
Hi, John.
We sure, right? Okay. Alright, let's get together again, guys.
You want him in there?
John.
John!
Hurry up! Need a pick?
You need to set that down a minute. Get some pictures. Bleep, bleep.
Lock your car first. Good man.
Just put that, like, down there. Try to help.
Let's just keep it casual and close.
Okay, here. You were gone.
And I showed Wayne 2 dresses, and he was like, either one would make you look hot. And I'm like, really?
That's Mama.
That would be. I was telling them, like, are you paying attention? Because like, I want next August for ours. So are you paying attention to what's happening here?
Is it next August?
That's what we're hoping for. And Mom agreed.
Really?
Yeah. I don't want anything big. I don't want anything expensive. I don't want anything crazy.
Well, that's just me. It's very simple. You know, so I wanted to get my nice. I wanted to get nice. I wanted to It's simple. What kind of simple do you want? Do you want a long dress? Do you want a short? What do you want?
I asked Justin, I said, you guys all are ready for this for your summer? Yeah, this girl was a disaster. I'm pulling it off. I'm like, that's not even funny. Oh, Katie. I said, I'm not going to tell Katie that one because I don't want you to die today. Oh, I know.
You know, I'm number one. Why are you hesitating? That's the part I don't understand. I'm like, no, you're going to get married. It's kind of
I'm
I gives this woman to be married to this man this day?
Her mother-in-law.
Thank you. Dearly beloved, Scott and Katie are beautiful individuals dedicated on living their lives together as one unit. This is the foundation of marriage, not the frills and materialism associated with love for gain, wealth, or advancement, but the true and full love that a husband and wife bestow upon each other. In understanding the other as an individual, spouses learn and show by example how loving each other for all that they are, good and bad, leads to marital fulfillment. Never will you be lonely. Your spouse will be there when you're done working, hobbying, or spending time with friends. Never will you be hungry. When you crave affection and devotedness, all you need do is ask your spouse. Never will you be poor. Your spouse's connection through the bond of marriage will keep you rich in emotion, learning, conversation, and company. Do you, Scott and Katie, come of your own free will to be married on this day?
I do.
Scott and Katie have declared their covenant to each other in the witness of your congregation today. Their first reading will be "I'll Be There For You" by Louise Cudden. I'll be there, my darling, through thick and through thin, when your mind's in a mess and your head's in a spin, when your plane's been delayed and you've missed the last train, when life is just threatening to drive you insane, when your thrilling whodunit has lost its last page, when somebody tells you you're looking your age, when your coffee's too cool and your wine is too warm, when the forecast said fine, but you're out in a storm, when your quick break hotel turns into a slum and your holiday photos only show a thumb, when you park for 5 minutes in the residence bay and return to discover you've been towed away, when the jeans that you bought in hope or in haste just stick on your hips and don't reach around your waist. When the food you like most brings you out in red rashes. When as soon as you boot up, the bloody thing crashes. So my darling, my sweetheart, my dear, when you break a rule, when you act the fool, when you've got the flu or when you're in a stew, when you're last in the queue, don't feel blue, because I'm telling you, I'll be there. You will now exchange the vows that will bind you in marriage. Katie and Scott, these vows are the promises that you'll state today, which carry the meaning of the promises you make in your heart each and every day for the rest of your lives. Look upon them for strength and joy in times of sorrow, and for peace and happiness always. Scott, please repeat after me. I, Scott, take you, Katie, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish. I give you my hand, my heart, and my love from this day forward, for as long as we both shall live. Katie, please repeat after me. I, Katie.
I, Katie.
Take you, Scott.
Take you, Scott.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Loving what I know of you.
Loving what I know of you.
And trusting.
And trusting.
What I do not yet know.
What I do not yet know.
I eagerly anticipate.
I eagerly anticipate.
The chance to grow together.
The chance to grow together.
Getting to know.
Getting to know.
The man you will become.
The man you will become.
And falling in love.
And falling in love.
A little more every day.
A little more every day.
I promise to love.
I promise to love.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
Through whatever life.
Through whatever life.
May bring.
May bring.
As Katie and Scott have made their solemn vow, we will celebrate with a reading dedicated to the promises made today. A Love Knot by Frances Nagel. Chains do not hold a marriage together. It is threads, hundreds of tiny threads which sew people together through the years. Picture hundreds, thousands of threads, as long as love is. For instance, picture kindness, how smoothly it unfurls. When people care as much about each other as they do themselves. Picture gentleness, when times are less than easy, a reassuring stream of soothing words. And respect, the essence of being a partner. Look to the joys of delighting in one another. The trials of being parents and the challenge none of us is prepared for. Imagine the tough, flexible fibers that nurturing a child together can create. And see laced around and through and everywhere, diamond twinkling filaments of laughter. These profound, priceless connections start so simply, with a smile perhaps, or an admiring glance. Picture again these hundreds, thousands of strands. As long as love is, longer than life. Today, a knot is being tied in the strands that and have started to spin out together. As your love is precious and eternal, so too your rings are fashioned from the most precious metals into a circle that has no end. May I have the rings? Scott, as you place the ring you have chosen for Katie onto her left hand, please repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love for you. Let it be a reminder that I am always by your side and that I will always be a faithful partner to you. Katie, as you place the ring you have chosen onto Scott's left hand, please repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
And devotion to you.
And devotion to you.
I pledge to you.
I pledge to you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will ever be.
And all that I will ever be.
As your wife.
As your wife.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I gladly marry you.
Gladly marry you.
And join my life to yours. By the authority vested in me, by God and the state of New York, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Woo! May I present to you now and forever Mr. and Mrs. Scott and Katie Reynolds. Woo!
One down, three to go. Only you don't know me.
Oh, I've got a little. Oh, well. Yeah, I know.
This way. Oh, all right.
Where did the girls go? Where did who? The girls go. Somewhere. Oh, okay.
Okay, leave me here. Bye. No.
Where are you going? I don't know. Okay. Hey, Dave. We keep my kid?
Huh?
We keep my kid?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, Kathy. I'm sorry.
Yeah, she lost me.
I usually can't hear.
Hi. I feel like I'm in the way. Thank you. Hi. Good to see you.
Well, I guess you said by your dad.
Was it you guys?
Yeah.
Wait, I don't know.
I would never pick up the cable and get a shake.
Thanks.
once we're mop and down, I'll do more. Like, I can do like a third. Let me get you a third card.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you. your attention, please. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Good evening and welcome to Katie and Scott's wedding reception. Everybody make some noise, please. My name is Eric. We're going to be your DJs for this evening, and we're going to have a lot of fun. If you want to hear something in just a little bit, come on up, let me know, and I'll do my best to try to get that on for you. At this time, it's time to get your wedding party introduced, so let's make some noise and welcome them as we get them introduced. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome first Father of the Groom, Terry Reynolds. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Mother of the Groom, Carol Inch and William Inch. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Parents of the Bride, Mr. and Mrs. John and Barbara Crandall. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to introduce your bridesmaid and groomsmen. First, we have Lindsay Malone, escorted by Wayne Forsythe. Please keep it going and help me welcome Matthew Lee Moss, escorted by Michael Cornish. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing your bridesmaid, Katie Melfi, escorted by Justin Bailey. Bieber, baby, it's all the same. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and help me welcome your best man and maid of honor. It's Alexa and Fabio, escorted by TK, sir! Ladies and gentlemen, please rise to your feet. Put your hands together and help me welcome on the first time as husband and wife, the new Mr. and Mrs. Scott. Ladies and gentlemen, this time the bride and groom will now share their very first dance together as husband and wife. The song they've chosen this evening is Etta James, A Sunday Kind of Love.
I love that song. Thank you. groom to escort his mother to the dance floor. Here he is. And the song that they've chosen this evening. And there are.
He got here in a cold, scared fright. And she took him and held him to her breast. And he sure was glad to get what Paul offered. Then he went to see and gym class, and I was a fresh transfer from a high school in New Canada,
into this middle of nowhere little high school. I was no idea. But we were in gym class, and honestly, I'm not into gym, like sports. That's just not my thing. So we were in this class, and it was dodgeball. I'm just standing here, like, I don't really care. I got hit a ball, oh well, you know. Scott, I'm assuming, out of the goodness of his heart, decided to include me in the game. So he decided to run up to me with this, you guys know this foam ball, right? It doesn't have a whole lot of mass to it. It's kind of like air, mostly. This guy's good at sports. I didn't know this, of course, at that time. And he just chucked this ball at, I don't know, like a baseball pitch, just kind of wailed at me. The thing was a curveball, and kind of did this little 180 thing. I was like, I had no idea. I was like, oh, ball coming at me. I was a little nerd. I wear like little glasses, and boom. Glasses fell. It was kind of slow motion. Broke into pieces. And I was just sitting here, of course, the nerd I am, sitting here doing, like, you know, physics in my head. It's like, how much force would that have to be for foam to break glasses into pieces? Of course, afterwards, I was mad. I was like, you broke my damn glasses! That's 10 years ago. As the years went by, we became really, really good friends. I watched him grow. From, you know, we were all immature teenagers, and I watched him grow into a very mature man. I personally don't subscribe to the views of the traditional matrimony, which is, you know, that we are here to gather before God and these witnesses, so on and so forth. I see that we control our lives, we take responsibility, and everything we do is up to us. Personally, from everything that I learned from science, is that the universe is very indifferent. Whatever happens, it's not because somebody is out there to get us or somebody like us. It just kind of happens. Any more than when we mow the lawn, we think about the dust mites. As such, it is not we who here to gather to witness this magical union. It's more like we have really gathered here to affirm what has already taken place. No need to go into details, but I know that every couple, including this one, have went through trials, good times and bad times. And I have personally seen that these two persevere through the good times and bad times. They have chosen voluntarily to affirm the love, support, and mutual affirmation that they give to each other. As far as I know, life is unpredictable. Whether we truly live under some kind of divine providence or truly just live under a very indifferent, careless universe, I respect the choices these two have started this union, which is indeed, as anybody who knows these two, is love, mutual support, and respect. I am comforted that that time is very relative, as Einstein would say. When you spend time with the ones you love, I think these two would know that time seems to be an eternity. Or of course, you spend time with the person that you loathe. That's another story. But as far as I know, I love these two, and a decade went by that fast. So imagine how much more time you guys can spend with each other, which is good times. And you imagine that in all seriousness, it's not this ceremony that we are here to witness what has already happened. It's because for the past few years, they have already chosen to be with one another through the choices which they have already made. And seriously, buddy, you guys make this work, because I'm pretty cheap, in case you haven't noticed this. I'm pretty cheap, okay? And I paid a good amount of money for this. And I'm not doing this damn thing again, all right? I'm pretty cheap. And like last night, I was the dancer. And I'm not even kidding. Like, seriously, good lord. Like, oh, chief right here? That's pretty bad. Oh, all right. I hope, I don't really pray, but I hope from the choices you two have already made, I have trust and, in that sense, faith that you two will continue the foundation which is already built, which is love, respect, and mutual support. From this moment on, I am feeling that I am blessed to see this, and I affirm and support the choices which you two have already made. And honestly, I can use some luck, honestly, here, man. Like, hook me up, seriously. I got no love around here, seriously. But I love you both. I'm very happy for what has already taken place. Appreciate it. I love you both. I wish you the very best. To Mr. and Mrs. Reynolds.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this time our maid of honor will now share a toast.
Good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I am Alexa, the proud best friend of the gorgeous bride tonight. Yay. Thank you. Similar to the best man in the Scott's friendship, I also met Katie in high school after I moved to Hannibal as a new student. Maybe Katie and Scott just must have felt bad for new students. Katie and I had a physics class together where she and I were literally the only females in the class. We became friends from there, and our friendship continued into college where we lived together in the dorms. Katie has been a dear friend of mine for the past 8 years, so of course I have many memories and stories of her that I can't share tonight. I didn't know Scott before he started dating Katie, but what I do know about Scott is not only can he take care of Katie if needed, but also how much he truly cares for her. Scott is an amazing guy, and I couldn't be any happier and feel blessed to be standing next to my best friend as she marries her best friend. It's the love Scott and Katie have for each other, the ability to laugh, and the strength in each other that will have them stand by each other's side on the good days and stand even closer on the bad days. And although I'm not married and never have been, that's not going to stop me from giving some marriage advice. Scott, never forget the two most important things. You're right, dear. And okay, honey, just buy that. Sometimes women really do need a new pair of shoes for each outfit and just secure a bad day. And always remember to have the last word in a fight. Yes, dear. So before I get into any trouble, I'll propose a toast. If everyone could please raise a glass and join me in congratulating the very beautiful bride and her handsome groom on the day we've all been waiting for. I love you both and wish you a lifetime of happiness. Woo!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for our toast right now? And at this time, I'd like to welcome our bride and groom as they'd like to share a few words with everyone here in attendance.
It will be very short and sweet. We would just like to thank you all very, very much for joining in this special day with us. And we hope you have a fantastic time, as we certainly will ourselves. So the food should be out all relatively shortly. Thank you all. I love you all.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, as she reiterated, the food will be out very shortly. We're going to have a great dinner. We've got some great things down the road as well. Enjoy dinner, guys.
Thank you.